What's up, guys?
Welcome back to the Gala Empire.
And we hope you guys got a lot accomplished. In today's video, what we'll be doing, covering over all November releases. You guys have to stay tuned to that. Make sure that you stay up to date with all our stuff by hitting that bell. And please, guys, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to
like, comment, and subscribe for us. And also let us know down below today, what is your favorite shoe from this lineup, from the November releases lineup, as well as what do you want to cop for personal, and what are you itching to resell to get that money? But without further ado, we'll get right into the video.
Get right into it. So the first shoe is
the Nike Dunk Low Veneers.
Yep.
What do you think about this shoe?
Now this shoe is, to me, I would not cop these, but I will flip these because it has too much going on with the green, the purple.
Reminds me of the Grinch.
Yes, it's not really a nice colorway for me personally. Guys, let us know in the comment section down below. But I love Dunks. I am a Dunk fan. It's SB Dunks. I love them.
No,
but
this is not an SB Dunk. This is a Nike Dunk.
Oh, this is a Nike Dunk. Okay, this is a Nike Dunk. I love Dunks. No matter Nike, SB, I love all Dunks. But it comes to a point where some of the colorways are really, really off.
I would rock these.
You would?
I would rock these.
What do you like about
this shoe? But I have to have a certain outfit for it. I have to have a certain outfit. You can't wear this shoe with anything. That's the difference. You got to know how to style it. But I would rock them. I like them. These are, and the plums are two of the styles that are released, that have been releasing this year due to, because of the 2001 Japan colorways exclusive. They're bringing them back. It's been 19 years. So they're finally bringing some exclusive styles back. And I really like what Nike and Dunks have been doing. The collabs have been going crazy. But resale on these right now is about roughly $300 to $350 for mostly all sizes. I'm pretty sure it's gonna stay like that. It's probably not gonna drop when the release date comes. Where to cop? Now, most skate shops are gonna have these.
Sure.
So I'm pretty sure they're gonna make sure that they do raffles, because of course, if it's resale, that's over $100 profit. People go crazy and it's too much going on. So I'm pretty sure you gotta call your local skate shops, ask them what they're gonna be doing. It is gonna be releasing on sneakers on November the 10th, as well as you can hit up all of your Nike brand retailers to see if they'll have them in stock as well.
Yes, and guys, remember, pay attention to what the Queen of the Gala said. She said skate shops. So if you in whatever, New York, New Jersey, Georgia,
Alabama,
everywhere, hit up all, type in on Google skate shops and call them and ask them.
Follow their Instagram, yes. Put your post notifications on.
It doesn't hurt to be on top of everything so that you'll be able to cop for yourself and be able to flip or keep for a personal pair.
Definitely.
So you have to pay attention to that. Alright guys, the second shoe is the Yeezy Boost Fade, and the release date is the 11/11. And now this shoe,
special number.
Yes, this is a special number. Now this shoe is, I don't know what I think about this shoe. What do you think about this shoe?
I don't know, man. Kanye is just, at this point, what can we do with him? I mean, it's subtle colors. It's not too bad. I'm pretty sure.
I just
have to see them in hand, I think.
Yeah,
I have to
see them in hand. It looks like it's going to be reflective, but I don't know.
I have to see them in hand because my mind totally changed after I copped the carbons and I seen them in hand. I'm like, these were very nice. But these so far, I don't know, guys. Let us down below what you guys think. But I definitely think I have to see them in hand before I make a judgment on these. Kanye has been putting out so many shoes that at this point, we're not even able to make a flip on them.
Yes.
Pretty sure, like,
for resellers, it's really hard because a lot of people getting so many Yeezys that love Yeezy. If you're a Yeezy fan, let us know what you think about these. I'm not really a Yeezy fan, so I'm going to be kind of biased towards Yeezys. So if you're a Yeezy fan, or if you're neutral, if you like certain Yeezys, let us know what you think about this shoe.
Definitely.
And give us some feedback on that. But
I mentioned, as for a reseller, I don't think we're gonna be able to make much profit on these. You're probably $30-$40 over.
Yeah, for people that didn't cop any Yeezys or been trying to copy Yeezys or want the first Yeezy, they will probably pay a good price for these. But a regular sneakerhead, a lot of people don't want to spend that much.
But these, I'm pretty sure you'll be able to cop on Yeezy Supply and Adidas. Those sites are heavily botted, so I suggest you do the footwork if you really want these and try to get them at your Yeezy retailers, your Adidas retailers. Mm-hmm. And if you have any stores near you that always drop all the latest Yeezys or latest Adidas, hit them up. Ask them if they're doing what they're doing for this release, because I'm sure they're gonna have it. But these, I'm pretty sure you have to do the footwork or get them on StockX, because Yeezy Supply and Adidas, you barely stand a chance on those. But yes, these fades, I have to see them in person. Maybe we'll be able to give you guys an in-hand shoe review, as well as we'll be able to bring you guys on our journey to cop the pair. So stay up to date for that. Don't forget, I will also put them in the description down below whenever we get a chance to do that video, when the release day come, which is November the 11th.
Yep.
All right, guys, the next shoe we have on the list is a Jordan 1, and it's the top 3 2.0s. Now, these definitely, probably most likely will have a good flip to them. I'm looking forward to seeing these shoes in hand, because I only started reselling about 2 years, almost 3 years ago, and I've never had a top 3 in my hand. So I need to see these. I'm definitely itching for these to resell, as well as I think I might, if I like them in hand, I might keep them. What do you think?
Yep, they're going straight to the top. Okay, let me tell you. Yes, these Jordans. Now, all my Jordan fans out there, I support you guys. You guys really show love, and you know, I love my Yeezy fans too. But you know, you Jordan fans, I know y'all love the Jordan 1s, and these 2.0s, I love the colorway. It have blue in it, it have red in it, it have black. Like, is you could cop this with so much stuff. And you know, I'm a Miami Heat fan, so it goes good with Miami Heat gear. So guys, tell us what you think. How can you cop these? What would you rock these with? Or if you don't like them, let us know too. But I really
right now,
these
prices on StockX are not even on, so I'm pretty sure resell on these will be nice.
All 2.0s right now. If you're a new reseller, if you're new to the game, if you trying to get information, you trying to learn, let me tell you right now, all 2.0s sell out. You will never find a 2.0 on the street. And if you do find on the street,
let me know where it is. I'll be there.
Yes, and it's not going to be no good price either. It's going to be expensive. And if you find a cheap 2.0, don't buy it.
But these definitely, these are nice, man. I like these. These are definitely go hard on a lot of outfits. You will most likely find these. Sneakers will drop them, of course. Your Jordan brand retailers will drop them, of course, as well as all the foot sites. Champs, Foot Locker, East Bay, you can put in your reservations for them. Just make sure you find what works best for you, so that you'll be able to cop on those apps. That really helps a lot. Whenever you don't win raffles, you could count on the apps. Definitely, we know we could count on the apps if we're not winning in any raffles. So put in the work, put in a lot of footwork, you'll get a lot of pairs, trust me.
Yeah, footwork make the dream work, I'm telling you.
All right
guys, the next shoe that we're going to talk about is the Atmos 11 Elephant Nike SB Dunks, and these come out November 11th. The thing that's gonna be hard is that it's not even on sneakers yet, so it's gonna be a really hard call.
It's not loaded up on sneakers.
It's gonna be difficult. So guys, that means you
and
have to
resell
call
is
all
looking nice,
beautiful. Like it's gonna be a very limited release. So you gotta call all local stores. You gotta make sure you enter all raffles. Be up to date with your information, because if you don't, you're not gonna cop.
Most likely this will be a your local skate shop exclusive, and sneakers, I don't think you're gonna be able to get these too easily. But if you really want these for personal, man, try your everything. Try make people into raffles for you. Pay people to sit at a first come first serve for you. If you're not able to stay, I don't know what you gotta do, but man,
find a way.
Whatever you can to avoid that resale price, because that resale price do not look good right now. So definitely, but they're nice. I like the elephant print. If you guys didn't know, elephant is my favorite animal.
Yeah,
but these are definitely, I like these.
Yeah, I like them too. Has blue in it.
I like them,
and it's I like the elephant print too of the shoe. It's really nice. It really stands out, and I hope you guys cop. And if let us know in the comment section down below if you like it.
Right,
not.
We hope we'll be able to give you guys a shoe review. Let us know down below if you would like to see that.
Or on foot review, let us know. Yes.
If we do cop for personal. But we'll let you guys know. Stay tuned.
All right, guys. The fourth shoe on the list is the What the Fives. These come out November 12th. And guys, we've been getting DMs since 2 weeks.
Months. A month plus. The demand for this shoe is super high. Super high.
If you're a reseller, I'm going to tell you right now, and you trying to just get one pair, you're going to sell it off bat. And if you want a personal, you got to put a lot of footwork to get these. Not going to be an easy cop. And if these get easy for you, then that's a lucky. Like, I want to know what city you're in, but
Definitely. These
are going to be a hard cop.
Right now, they dropped on, as I'm looking at it, they dropped a little bit on StockX. Before last week, they were sitting at 300s. Now they dropped below a little bit on buy now. Sell now is same thing, 250, 270, 280. They dropped a little bit as we get closer to release. But don't worry about StockX when it comes to certain shoes. The demand for these are high.
And guys, remember,
extremely high.
Everything we're telling you guys is based off right now. By release date, these prices might go up, skyrocket.
These might skyrocket.
Or it might go down. I'm telling you guys for a warning. Like, if you're debating on off us, if you should cop it or not, I'm just telling you right now,
pay attention to stock.
Pay attention to the market, because this video will be uploaded soon and you guys need to pay attention that this is very early information. So you got to really be aware of what we're saying. And
of your circumstances as well. Yep. As make sure you keep, like we said, pay attention to stock and know the demand that you have. If you have a lot of customers that are asking for these, get as many pairs as you can. Do the footwork. Footwork you can always count on. Online, skeptical, but footwork is everything.
And if you know this pair is rare in your city, that mean anybody that's in your city that want them gonna pay that price that they have to get them. So
definitely
you gotta pay attention to that too. Pay attention to what the people are saying so you know what to cop and what not to. So
as well, these I'm pretty sure you'll be able to cop them as well on the foot sites, Champs, Foot Locker, Foot Action, as well as Sneakers is most definitely gonna drop them. They already did a shock drop for them when they did the Fire Reds. Yeah. So a lot of pairs are already out, but the demand is still high since there's a lot of people that want them. So be on the lookout for that.
Yeah, but without done talking about resale talk, what do you like about the shoe? Or what you think about the shoe?
I actually want them.
Oh, wow.
I actually think I could, I know I could rock them, but it depends. I gotta see it in my hand. The red might be different. The material might be different. I really want that yellow to be honey mustard, but it doesn't look honey mustard in pictures. So I gotta see these in my hand. If it's a personal shoe that I have to cop, I gotta see them in my hand before I say any judgment, because my mind could change. Like,
yeah.
And you?
I wouldn't cop these. I feel like I got mustard and ketchup on my feet, and I'm not really about that. But these, a lot of people are going crazy for these. I really want to know how these look in hands, so I can be like, wow, if they look good
or
not.
Give you guys a review. Don't forget, guys, every single shoe we talk about, we're gonna try to get most of them on a review for you guys, so definitely stay tuned to that. Every weekend that there's a release or every week there's a release, we're always uploading reviews so you guys will be able to see the shoe in hand.
Yes, and if you want to see most of these shoes or all of them as a shoe review, don't forget to hit that like button, that share button, and please hit that bell, because we need you guys to stay up to date so you don't miss those reviews.
And let us know what you want to see as well.
Yes.
So the next one we have are the Nike Sakai Waffles. Now, there are two different colorways coming out. We have the Royal Fuchsia, as well as we have the Black and White. Which one do you prefer?
Black and White. And I know a lot of people are going to be, especially looking Queen of the Galaxy, going to be like, I'm a basic person. But let me tell you guys, Black and White really looks nice, because I feel like the way how they did this shoe, it really pops out and is also a better colorway when it comes to outfits and stuff like that, because I feel like you can't really rock the Royal Fuchsias with anything, and because it's gonna throw off the whole outfit. So
resale is looking nice on these. Yes. Right now retail is 180, after tax probably 191. Both all sizes right now are sitting at 500 plus. So you're going to make a nice profit on these if you cop these. Pretty sure you'll be able to hit them on Sneakers, sneakers are gonna have them, as well as your Nike brand retailers. You can always call and ask if they're getting these, what type of release style they're gonna be doing for them. Pretty sure since it's such a hype release, they're gonna be doing raffles only. Enter all raffles that you can. Guys, even if you think there's no chance, you never know, that just might be a shot, so.
Yeah, and if any local stores do a first come, first serve, best be on top of that, because that's gonna be a really big first come, first serve. And another thing too is, advice tip that I wanna give real quick is that on StockX, when you're watching the market and the price is as high as it is right now, and we're getting close to that release date and it stays that number, just know the price is gonna be really right when you actually get on the release day and get the pair in hand. But you have to really pay attention, because if the price is getting too close to retail and it's a week until the shoe comes out, that means it's probably not gonna do that good. So really, that's how you really determine the market. So stay tuned, stay posted and on the market, and pay attention
until after release. Until after 10 o'clock, which is the time sneakers always drop everything, stay on StockX. You'll know what sizes are doing the best. You would know what sizes are not. You would know if it's still Chicago. You would know everything. That'll determine everything. So, guys, stay tuned to the market. Really stay tuned. But for me, I think I'm copping the future, the fuchsias. I just want to be different. I don't want no regular black and white shoe. I want to actually cut it out, be able to style. But I think I do like these better than the old Sakai waffles.
Yeah, the waffles. And
these are called Vapor waffles, and the other ones are waffles. But I like the Vapor waffles better.
Yeah, in my opinion, the sole is different. And another thing too is that I feel like the Royal Fuchsias are more of a women's shoe anyway. But I don't know. You guys, let me know. Guys, let me know. Men, I need you to tell me, which ones do you like more, the fuchsias or the black and white ones, which are the
And let us know if you get them, what would you do with them?
Yeah, if you a flip or not. And resellers, I know you guys have to compete with StockX, but right now StockX is what runs the market, so you have to leave that as an account to everything. But guys, stay tuned to that, and we're making sure that we bring as much value as we can to you guys. Alright guys, the next shoe is the Midnight Navy Japans. These come out November 14th. I really want this shoe. Yes. And it's really looking really nice. It's a blue colorway. You already know I love blue. Navy blue, royal blue, whatever type
Any
of blue.
Any blue.
I love it. I love it. I love it. I really want these for the toe. What do you want, Claire?
No, I would not cop these for personal at all. I do not like them. Resale?
Ridiculous.
Right now it's at $250 and we're not even close to release date. These are not gonna do so well. So for me, it's probably gonna be a little a cop for a little bit of profit to flip, but definitely not the personal. Nope.
Well, I like that. That is not going for much, so it's easy to get
it's
my
easier
size.
To cop.
And also, the more
these
pairs, the better. Guys, if you're new to reselling, I know you have to build up your money, but if you've been in reselling for a minute, these are the releases that you must capitalize on, because the more pairs you have, the more you could like sell, the more you can give out deals, the more customers you can meet.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to really capitalize on the small releases that's not really going to do so much to build up your client.
All right, guys, the next shoe that releases on November the 14th is the Yeezy 700 V3 Safflowers. Now, resale is looking
fire.
Nice on these. Right now, some sizes are not even up on StockX, and the ones that are going for like $950, $2,000, but I'm pretty sure those are going to go down. But right now, I'm pretty sure these are probably going to have a limited amount of pairs to it. The 700 V3s have been doing limited quantities compared to the 350s that Kanye had just been throwing at us. But these are definitely a personal cop if I were to get my hands on these and my size for retail. What do you think about them?
Yes, this shoe, I don't really like this shoe. It looks like a more like an alien on my feet. But guys, I know you guys know about the review that we did on the Osiris. These are like the same thing, but just different color.
Yellow,
yes,
my favorite
yellow.
Color.
So you guys actually have to look at this shoe and actually pay attention to the details of the shoe. If you like 700, this is a different shoe.
I'm pretty
Never
sure these
before.
Will be glow in the dark too.
Yeah, most likely. Well, if we do a shoe review on these, we'll give you all the details of this. But for me, I would not do a personal call.
Wow. But me, I like these shoes. If you like these shoes, comment down below. We are a team together. I like these shoes. I want them. I think they're fire. It's a nice colorway. Definitely something Kanye finally took his time to put out.
All right, guys. The next shoe we're going to do is the Nike Dunk Low Ceramics. And these shoes are really nice. Really definitely
flashy.
Will cop. Yes, very flashy. I love the shoe. And these released November 12th.
19th.
19th. Yes, 19th. I'm all over the place. And these are really nice. I got to be on top of this shoe because I really want this.
Resale is looking beautiful right now.
Resale,
pairs are
yes.
like at $1,000, $780, $690. Depending on whatever size you get, it's still a beautiful flip. Retails only for $100. Every dunk only retails for $100 to $130 the most. But man, these are nice.
These are nice. Resellers are really looking for this shoe. So if you want a personal copy, you really got to be on top of raffles, on top of all type of entries.
Skate shops,
first sneakers, come, first serve, if any.
Even if you feel like you don't win on sneakers, just try.
Yes,
you never know.
One. Yep. So
you never know, man.
Always
stay tuned.
Try to do any way you can. Try to be involved into it so you can get your opportunity to win.
Definitely.
All right, guys. The last shoe of today's video is the Jordan 1 Metallic Golds. And these look really nice to me. Well, I don't really know how I like them right now yet.
Gotta
see them in hand. And the release date is November 30th. So it is at the end of the month. We're in the beginning still. So I give myself time before I decide on what I like about the shoe, what I don't yet. But what do you think about the shoe?
I don't like the shoe at all. I don't like that metallic look all over the shoe. I feel like it's tacky. It throws it off. Especially because it's such a subtle gold on the shoe. I feel like they should have made the Nike check gold. And like put more gold onto the shoe instead of just on the heel. On the top of the heel of the shoe. I feel like that's just too simple.
Yeah.
But the resale on these is looking nice at the moment. Even though it's all the way towards the end of the month. Resale is looking nice. Some pairs are going $400, $500, $300. So resale is still looking nice at the moment, but I'm pretty sure all ones always end up selling. So these will all definitely be a sale. So there's nothing to be you gotta make sure that you be on top of your information to cop these. If you wanna make a little profit, I'm sure by the time release day come, in my opinion, these will go down.
Yep.
And then take time to go back up again.
And that is a very accurate opinion because all Jordan 1s, if you look back at the previous ones, even the ones that have the most profit as of right now, they always on release date, they do a big dip. And then over time, they go high. And then you can't even try to get a pair because it's
especially,
too expensive.
Especially the ones that are mass produced, the ones that have a bunch of pairs. Yeah, they definitely end up going down and then end up going back up. That's how it usually is for any pair that's not limited.
Yes.
But guys, this was the November 2020 shoe release calendar. Let us know down below if we missed anything or if there's a release that's added into it that you guys realize. Please let us know down below and let us know if you want to. If you do add it, we'll definitely try to give you guys an in-hand shoe review if we do end up cupping those pairs. But without further ado, we hope you guys
got a lot accomplished.
And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Comment and share, whatever it is.
Yes.
Do what you gotta do for us. Let us know that you support us. But guys, we are out. Stay tuned for the next video.